Hello everyone, I'm Arthur. I want to present you shortly architecture issues. Have you ever missed whose services you use, or what do you have in the kitchen or where are the keys? Organization, coordination and ordering is necessary if you want to still have remnants of control over developing projects. At the beginning, we will tell ourselves about the application architecture. First, what is architecture for and what is it? Second, example of architectural problems and solutions. First, selection of technology. If you want to create an app, you are going to need some external service ID. Email, payment services or advertisement services, for example with pictures encouraging viewers to click, money for you. Application may consist of parts, internal elements like website, cell application or database. When planning creation of an app, you need to consider what kind of external and internal services you need. Then you have to combine them. These matters constitute the architecture of the system. You also need to take into account different factors, we will come back to that later. You will find out what factors are important when choosing services and how to create connections between them. Suppose we want to create an app consisting of website, cell app and database. We should also add the above-mentioned internal services, emails, for example Gmail, payment service, for example PayPal, and advertisement service, for example AdWords. In order to enable connection between internal and external services, we need to select proper technology. In order to do so, let's choose backend, PHP, Symfony, frontend, mobile apps by React, JS and MySQL database. We matched the tools with preferences and experience of our team. Next step is to set the environment's expectations. Depending on the expected traffic, frequency of website visits or business need for communication, we should select proper number and quality of the servers. Some servers require a lot of disk storage for archivization of legal documents or loading of images. In that case, we can use network drive. If we are going to process a large amount of information simultaneously, more RAM and bigger processor may be necessary. If we don't know the traffic or it is hard to determine its scale, we can use cloud architecture, which is scalable. You can increase or decrease IT resources as needed. We can also divide servers with regard to security level, high level of control DDK, dedicated servers, allowing you to create backup copy and determine means of communication between servers. And low level control, serverless. If control isn't our top priority and we want to save time and resources, the latter seems like a good idea. We can manage the servers using tools like Docker or Kubernetes, enabling for allocation of server resources. We can scale as appropriate, for example only database or only disk to files. It provides also compliance of developer and production environment and better control dependency. You can find exemplary project with documentation at docker.com, prepared containers are available at hub.docker.com. We recommend you stick to the end, and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. Last advice, always remember to adapt and optimize given environments. There is a difference between production clipboard, safety is the key, and developer clipboard, problem diagnosis first. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.